Hi, my name is Henry Bridge, and I'm the product manager for Native Client. I'm here today to talk to you about our developer pre-release of the Native Client SDK. This video will help you get familiar with the SDK and with developing web apps that take advantage of native code. For those of you who are new to this technology, Native Client is an open source project that allows you to run native code in a web browser. This capability allows you to take the many useful existing libraries written in languages like C or C++ and use them in your web app. For example, say you wanted to run photo filters on your web gallery application. You could use existing libraries that allow users to seamlessly perform smooth image manipulation on your photos without leaving your website and without installing other software. Web applications that use Native Client consist of parts that are written in HTML, JavaScript, and CSS, as well as parts that are written in native code. The HTML, JavaScript, and CSS parts are deployed as text files. For the native code portions, you'll need a compiler that produces Native Client binaries. The Native Client SDK comes with a modified version of GCC that will compile C or C++ code to native code. Imagine you want to write a video editing application for the web. You can write your UI and basic program logic, such as metadata, field editing, and timeline controls, in HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. But when it comes time to implementing the code to modify the video data, what's the right approach? You could implement the video editing on the server, but this approach would waste bandwidth and also feel slow. On the other hand, you could try to implement the video editing code that would run on the client in JavaScript, but this would be difficult to implement and it would also be slow. Native Client allows you to get the best of both worlds. Download the data once to the client, and do the editing there. Periodically, the application can just push a changelog up to the server for processing, without impacting performance. To get started, download our SDK from code.google.com/p/nativeclient-sdk. The Getting Started guide on this site will walk you through installing the SDK so you can begin building applications. Once you've set up your development environment properly, navigate your browser to the Hello World example. Then, click the Hello World button and you'll get a dialog that pops up that's already made a round trip into native C++ code. Now let's see how this works. You can view source on the web page and see that the Hello World HTML page loads the native client module using an embed tag. On successful load, a global variable pointing to the native client module is set. An onclick handler is then set for the Hello World button, which in turn calls the Hello World function on the native client module. Following this function call down into native code, observe that the invoke call determines what method was called via string compare. Since the Hello World function was called, it then calls invoke HW, which copies Hello World into the result buffer. The result is then passed back to JavaScript when the function returns, and it's displayed as an alert dialog in JavaScript. Now try modifying the Hello World text that's passed back. Recompile the native client module by opening up a terminal, CDing to the SDK/examples directory, and running make. Reload the web page, and the message will change when you click the Hello World button. While this simple Hello World example is a long way from a compelling application, we hope it's clear how Native Client makes it possible to weave high-performance native C and C++ methods into a web application. To make the best use of the power of running native code in a web application, Native Client includes APIs to expose useful functionality beyond message passing between JavaScript and native code. To handle resource management, Native Client provides a set of low-level, Linux-like APIs, such as malloc and mmap, that allow you to handle resource allocation in the sandbox system environment. In order to access browser resources like the network or communicate with the DOM, Native Client exposes NPAPI. Finally, to provide platform-independent multimedia interfaces, such as 2D and 3D graphics and audio, Native Client modules can interface with the NPAPI Pepper interfaces to OpenGL ES 2.0 and to a stereo audio system. As an example of the kinds of compelling experiences you can create with these APIs, here's some footage of a port we've done of Nexius, an open-source, modern Quake engine that we ported to Native Client and to OpenGL ES 2.0. If you're attending Google I/O, come to our Beyond JavaScript talk for a deep dive on the SDK, or come meet the team at the Developer Sandbox. For more resources, visit our site at code.google.com/p/nativeclientsdk.